Until September. At least at Florence's house, you get to eat decent food.
My food isn't decent?
It's not even food.
All right, I'm through being the nice one. You all owe me $6 a piece for the buffet. Come on.
Buffet? Hot Diet Colas and two sandwiches left over from when you went to high school?
Three. One, two, three.
Again, sports.
What did Forrest Smithson carry in his hand for inspiration in the 1908 Olympics?
Extra jockey shorts.
Is that your answer?
If you say that one more time, I'm taking you hostage, I swear to God.
We all think that. Yeah.
He carried a Bible.
That's right. The woman's unbelievable.
How could you possibly know about the 1908 Olympics?
From Phil. Phil knew more about sports than any man I ever knew. You know, I think we'd still be married today if only I could have won the Kentucky Derby.
Don't get that mournful look in your eye, gang. The man lost your entire life savings at the track. Two. One, two. Signs of nature.
What is the strongest muscle in a man's body?
Before, after.
You're not still sending Phil money, are you?
Yeah, she does. A few $100, just until he gets his life straightened out.
He's been trying to get straightened out for 2 years. How bent was he? I can't help it. Every time I hear his voice on the phone, I end up sending him a check. He's so good at it. He puts a little whimper in because he knows it gets to me.
I would never support an ex-husband. Not until women are getting equal pay with men.
Right.
Well, you have to look at it both ways. I mean, what's sauce for the goose is sauce for the gander.
You're gonna be some big hit in Florida.
You give up on the strongest muscle?
The tongue. Don't ask me how I know that. One, two, three. Sports and leisure.
What's a southern dish made out of big small intestine called?
Airplane food. Chitlins.
Hello?
Oh, hello, Phil. I was just talking about you.
Somebody hide her checkbook.
So, have you been, Phil?
You sound good. Haven't been sleeping, eh?
He's whimpering. This is going to cost me.
Hanging girl, remember the Alamo. So, what have you been doing, Phil?
Mostly thinking of me? Oh, what's that, me? We're talking four figures here.
You're in a bind? What kind of bind?
You want us to cut the wire?
You owe 2 months back rent? Aw, oh, gee, Phil.
How much does it come to?
$1.6 million.
Oh, gee, Phil, I wish I could help you out, but I'm broke myself. I just paid my last 2 years' taxes.
That's it. Hang in, girl. Win this one for the Gipper.
I know you hate to ask, Phil, and I hate to turn you down.
Hang up. Hang up before his voice cracks.
What's wrong with your voice, Phil? No, Phil, don't do that. Listen, I'll send you $300. Is that all right?
Gloria Steinem hates you.
Stop coughing, Phil. Sympathy's not going to work with me. I'm sending you $500.
Even money. She goes to $650.
All right, Phil. I've got to go. It was nice talking. It's what? Our anniversary.
When?
My God, next week, you're right. Well, the same to you, Phil. Yeah, sure, $650's fine. Okay, bye.
He sounded like Orphan Annie in a snowstorm, what do you wonder?
You give your ex-husband $650, and your best friends get to eat the Dead Sea Scrolls?
I'm going to on my character.
Go ahead, shoot me. If you mean it, I have my gun here.
What is the oldest known vegetable in the world?
You are.
You think I don't know? There are two Spanish brothers who live in this building who are crazy about me. Sexiest guys you ever saw. Well, I must be crazy. Why am I sending a shiftless gambler like Phil $750?
Hand me my purse, I'll shoot her right now.
Is that your final answer?
Yes, you are the oldest vegetable known to man.
Wrong! It's the pea.
Then you're runner-up.
The kids today, they're smarter than us. You know, why go through all the trouble of marriage when you can have a roommate? I'm going to start looking on the bus tomorrow.
Entertainment.
Which group starred in the movie Rock Around the Clock?
Everybody, all together.
Bill Haley and the Comets!
Hello?
sweetheart.
I told you not to call me tonight. Well, you know I do, darling. All right. Just a minute. Mickey, it's your husband.
Yeah, I wish you were having an affair with him. Then he wouldn't be bothering me all the time.
Hello, Stanley. You made yourself dinner. What'd you have? Lamb chops.
That's very good, Stan.
Your husband can make lamb chops?
He boils them in water.
No, I didn't know. No, I shouldn't show up tonight. You're kidding. Okay. Yeah, okay. Okay, bye.
What did I tell you?
What's the matter?
Florence is missing.
Oh my what?
Gosh. I told you guys that something was up.
What do you mean missing?
Well, she wasn't home all day. She canceled her facial and her pedicure. She didn't show up to her yoga class or her spiritual advisor. No one has seen her the entire day, and Stanley just spoke to her husband.
Wait a minute. No one is missing for one day.
Mm-hmm. That's right. You've got to be missing for 48 hours before you're missing.
She loves the Museum of Modern Art. Maybe she went there.
Yeah. Maybe she got locked in the museum. I once talked to a security guard there for 20 minutes until I realized he was a statue.
She's got charge cards for 47 stores. If 8 hours go by without her shopping, New York shuts down.
Maybe she was mugged.
Do you know what she carries in her handbag? Tear gas, a siren, and a police radio. If you tap her on the shoulder, a squad car shows up.
I'm really getting a bad feeling in my bones. Someplace in trouble right now.
What are we guessing for? I'll call Sydney.
Wait a minute. Don't start anything yet. Just because we don't know where she is doesn't mean somebody else doesn't know. She's seeing someone on the side.
You mean like a hypnotist?
Are you on Valium? Did you ever think of taking speed so you can keep up with the rest of us? Wasting time. I'm going to call Sydney and find out what's what.
Hello?
Sydney. Olive. I just heard. Listen, Sydney, do you have any idea where she could be?
She what?
You're kidding. Why? No, I didn't know. All right, Sid. Listen, you just sit tight, and the minute I hear anything, I'll let you know. All right. Goodbye. They broke up.
Who?
Florence and Sydney.
Don't tell me.
Oh, I can't believe it.
But they were such a happy couple.
After 14 years.
14 years doesn't mean you're a happy couple. It just means you're a long couple.
Yeah. What happened?
The man wants out, that's all. Oh, she'll go to pieces. I know Florence. She's going to try something crazy.
She used to say, our marriage will last 100 years.
What happened?
She missed by 86 years. There's no one listening to what I'm saying. She's going to try something crazy. What if she goes out and tries to kill herself?
Will you shut up, Mickey? Stop being a policewoman for 2 minutes.
Where'd she go, Olive?
She went out to kill herself.
What did I tell you?
Are you serious? That's what the man said. She went out to kill herself. She didn't want to do it at home because her mother was sleeping over.
Why did she want to kill herself?
Why? Because she's an hysteric, that's why.
You mean she actually said, I'm going to go out and kill myself. What, she didn't leave a note?
No, she sent a telegram.
A suicide telegram?
If she wants to kill herself, why did she send a telegram?
Because the quicker it gets there, the quicker she has a chance to be saved.
Oh, I get it. She doesn't really want to kill herself. She just wants sympathy.
Right. We get people like that all the time. They crave attention. We get this guy that calls us every Saturday morning from the top of George Washington Bridge. We don't even answer it anymore.
I don't know. There's always a first time. Maybe this is the one time she actually means it.
Please. Florence wears her seatbelt in a drive-in movie.
We can't just sit here and do nothing.
Well, is there some place we can look for her?
Where? Where would you look for a suicidal person who wants to live?
Of course. If you're going to kill yourself, where's the safest place to do it?
Yes.
With your friends.
Oh, I'll leave the door.
Wait a minute. She may just be hysterical. Let's play it nice and easy. If we're calm, maybe she'll be calm.
Right, that's exactly how we do it with those people out on the ledges. Just very calm and soothing, just like a priest.
What would we say to her?
No, nothing. We say nothing. nothing, as if we haven't heard a thing.
Oh, maybe we should notify the police.
Well, what do you think I am, for Christ's sake?
Are you all through with this discussion? Because she could have died old age up in the hall. Everybody sit down, ask us a question.
Okay, well, roll the dice, get a category.
Who gives a crap what the category is? Just ask a question.
Well, my mind, it's too logical. I can't ask a question if I don't have a category.
Sports and leisure.
Not sports and leisure, it's too tough.
I can't believe it. Shut up, Thorns, wait a minute.
Movies, entertainment, open the door.
Hello, Mary. Hello, Florence. We practically forgot all about you.
One more piece of the pie is all we need.
Hello, girls.
Hi, Florence.
Could you repeat the question?
Oh, I didn't ask it yet. Name three actors who played Charlie Chan on screen.
I'm sorry I'm late.
Oh, 5, 10 minutes, big deal. There's some sandwiches if you're hungry. I've been eating all day.
Never mind.
What was the question?
Three actors who play Charlie Chan.
Is there anything to drink?
Oh, sure. Coke, Pepsi, 7-Up, anything.
I meant hard stuff. Do you have any hard stuff? Dubonnet?
Dubonnet?
No, I just killed my last case.
Nothing is very important.
The three actors you played who?
Charlie Chan. It's Charlie Chan. How many times do I have to say
it? Everybody, take it easy. Calm down.
Is there anyone who called for me?
Call? Not that I can remember. Did anyone call for Florence?
No.
Were you expecting a call?
Me? Who would call for me?
Three actors who play Charlie Chan, is that it?
That's it. That's the question. You got it.
You mean in the same picture?
What would they want three Charlie Chans in the same goddamn picture for?
Yeah, two Tarzans in the same picture once.
Never! Never two Tarzans in one picture!
One of them pretended to be Tarzan.
Well, then it wasn't two Tarzans, it was one Tarzan and one pretending
all
to be Tarzan.
Right, take it easy, take it easy.
Yeah, calm down, everyone. I'm sorry, everybody's just making me nervous.
That's because you make everybody else nervous.
Okay, fine, I'll just go out and kill myself.
Pretty cute. What is it? 12? 4?
No! It's 11. It says 12, but it's only 11.
Yeah.
When is it gone and played? No, it's still early.
What's your favorite category? Movies.
I wouldn't know one from another.
Oh, you'd know this one. Name three actors who played Tarzan in the movies.
Charlie Chan! It's Charlie Chan!
Peter Ustinov, Werner Olin, and Sidney Toler, excuse me.
Oh, where are you going?
Bathroom?
Oh. Alone?
I always go alone. Why?
Oh, no reason. You're gonna be in there long?
As long as it takes!
Are you crazy letting her go in there by herself?
How is she gonna kill herself in the jaw?
How do you mean how? She can take pills, she can slash her wrist.
It's the guest bathroom. There's nothing in there. What is she gonna do? Swallow a towel?
Well, she could jump.
That's why there's no window in there.
It's only 6 inches wide.
Well, what if she just sticks her head out the window and starts slamming it on her neck?
She can also flush herself into the East River.
I'm telling you, she's not gonna do anything.
Shh, quiet.
She's crying.
We should do something. She shouldn't be there crying all alone.
You wanna go in there and cry with her?
She's crying out. In what picture the clown Rains and Betty Davis?
Mr. Skeffington, I'm gonna go for a walk.
Where are you going to walk this time of night?
I don't know. Along the river's nice.
The river?
You heard something, didn't you?
No.
Yes. You think I'm gonna try something because then he dumped me after 14 years of marriage? The dirty bath, I gotta go.
Don't do it, Florence, please.
Don't stop me. Don't try to stop me.
Come on, Florence. This way. We're your friends. You can talk to us.
I still love him. There's no point in going out.
Go, Florence.
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 Florence. Florence. Florence. Florence. Florence. Florence. Florence. Florence. Florence. Florence. Florence. Florence. Florence. Florence. Florence.
didn't take anything. What did you take?
Nothing.
You swear?
I swear.
On your children's life?
No, on my husband. Oh.
How many pills?
What kind of pills?
I don't know, a little green ones. I just grabbed anything out of Sydney's cabinet. Oh, I must have been crazy.
I'll call Sydney, he'll check.
Don't call Sydney. If he hears I took a whole bottle.
What? A whole bottle? You took a whole bottle of pills? Somebody call an ambulance.
You don't even know what kind.
Well, what's the difference? She took an entire bottle.
Maybe they were vitamins. She could be the healthiest one in this room.
Okay, slap her face. Now open a window. Let's go.
Okay, walk around. Don't let her go to sleep. Come on.
Keep walking. Rub her wrists. Keep her circulation going. Keep her moving.
The hospital is busy.
Isn't there a doctor in the building?
He's an optometrist. If she goes blind, I'll call him.
Please let me sit. Please watch my mic.
No, you are not sitting down until we get those pills out.
They're out. They're out. I got them out.
What do you mean you got them out?
I had a pizza on Broadway. I threw up in the elevator. I don't think a dog did it. I just get a drink.
I'll get it. Do you want the Frisco Sprite?
Will you just get her a drink?
You sure?
I'm sure.
Okay, Florence, you get a good night's rest, honey. I guarantee you things are going to be looking up in the morning.
Right. Hide all your belts and plastic bags.
Oh, Florence.
I know.
Florence.
I know.
Florence.
I know. What am I going to do, Olive?
You're going to wash down those pills with some hot black coffee. I'll make it.
It's a lousy marriage, but I don't want this divorce.
You want a brownie? A chocolate brownie? It's about 3 weeks old, but I could toast it.
If Cindy and I break up, I'll be the first in my family to be divorced.
They told me your mother and father were divorced.
Since then, my sister's still married. Separated, but married.
How about some espresso? With Stella D'Oro cookies?
How dare he treat me like this? How dare... Oh, on my neck! Oh, God, on my neck!
Oh. What did you do?
It's a nurse bathroom. I get in the neck.
What can I do?
Give me a towel. Hot towel, very hot.
What about some aspirin?
Aspirin's good. And some brandy. Oh, I can't move my neck.
Hot towel, aspirin, brandy. Anything else?
Bengay to rub it after. And a scarf. A woolen scarf. Cashmere is better if you have it. All of my new swimming was coming. Every night I'd tiptoe into the bathroom and I would pray. Please, God, please help me save my marriage. Please, God, tell me what to do. Tell me what I'm doing wrong. Then I hear Sydney in the bedroom saying, please, God, make her shut up.
Here, put this scarf on.
I'm not a complainer. I never try to change Sydney. He wears a toupee two sizes too big. He looks like an English sheepdog. I never said a word.
Drink them down with brandy.
Now he's into cowboy boots. 5'3½. He wears cowboy boots. They come up to his knees. He looks like he jumped off 100-foot horse. And he's into languages. He's studying Russian at the new school. Instead of yes, he says da. Everything is da.
There's all the men saying chorus.
I'm married to a 5'3" man, wears an oversized toupee and boots up to his knees and walks around saying da, and he walks out on me.
Relax, relax, damn it. Your neck feels like Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Sometimes I think I'm crazy. Sometimes I think I have a belong in an institution.
Later, if the massage doesn't work.
That doesn't smell like Ben Gay.
You're right, it's toothpaste.
This is helping.
Because you won't relax. Have you always been this tense?
Since I was a baby, I could chew through a thick sirloin steak just with my gums. I don't blame Sydney. I cry, I pant, hysterical.
If this hurts, just tell me, because I don't know what the hell it is I'm doing.
I take advantage of you all. I lose our friendship. I know I get on your nerves.
No, you don't.
I do.
You don't.
I do. I see your richer teeth when you talk to me. You used to have much longer teeth.
Okay, how does your neck feel?
Better.
Good.
But it never lasts long.
Maybe this time.
No, it just came back.
Drink your brandy.
Won't go down.
I'll get you a plunger. Aw, drink your brandy, you'll feel better.
Thank God the kids are away at summer camp. They'll be spared this until September.
Please drink your brandy.
Oh, look, you may thirst yourself. Tell me what to do.
First of all, you're gonna calm down and relax. Then you and I are going to figure out a whole new life for you.
A whole new life? Without Sydney? What kind of a life is there without Sydney?
I don't live with Sydney, and I'm very happy. Come on, Florence, you can do it. Believe me.
Oh, but you went through it yourself. How did you get through it?
I drank. 4 days and 5 nights. I couldn't work. I ate a pound of Jamaica almond fudge every night. I gained 14 pounds, 7 on each hip. I looked like I was carrying my laundry in my pockets. But I got through it.
Sydney, what about him? He's human too. How's he gonna get through it?
He's a man. Men have freedom. He can meet women anywhere. We have to donate a kidney and hope the man is grateful and single.
I think Sydney's already thinking about the women at a time like this.
I guarantee you by tomorrow night he'll be at a singles bar, sitting on top of a stool on top of 2 telephone books. Bless you.
What's the matter with you? Sinus condition.
What are you doing? Living by myself because I'm lonely. That's why.
But you have so many friends.
Friends go home at 11 o'clock. Come on, Florence, I am proposing to you. What do you want, a damn ring?
I really mean it, Oliver. So what I could do around here, I could turn this place into something out of Architectural Digest.
Florence, Sports Illustrated is fine with me.
Now, let me do something, Oliver. Let me do something.
All right. Tomorrow you can build me a terrace, anything you want.
You'll eat like you've never eaten before. You like shosh like Caucasian and hot Russian bellinis?
I'll make it for dinner. Oh, you don't have to cook. I like eating out.
Breakfast and dinner at home. We'll save a fortune, and we'll need it, because I'm not taking a single penny from Sydney.
Wait a minute, let's not be hasty.
You told me to have self-respect. How can I have self-respect if I take money from Sydney?
Money is one area where self-respect doesn't work.
That's him! That's Sydney! I can tell it's written.
Hello? Oh, hello, Sydney.
I'm not here. Don't tell him that I'm here.
Yeah, she's here.
Why'd you put me out here? I told you not to tell him that I'm here.
Yeah, she told me everything.
How does he sound? Is he okay? Does he want to talk to me? Because I do not want to talk to him.
Yes, I agree with that.
You agree with what? Don't agree with him. Agree with me. I'm your friend.
Well, personally, I think she's taking it very well, Sydney.
You call this taking it well? I'm not taking it well. I'm taking it like a crazy woman.
Yes, I know you have. And you've been wonderful that way. God bless you.
Don't God bless him! Why did you God bless him?
He sneezed! What do you want from me?
Sorry, ask me if he wants to talk to me.
Sydney, would you like to talk to her?
Do you need a phone? I'll talk to him.
Oh. You don't want to talk to her?
He doesn't want to talk to me?
Yes, I see. I understand. I agree. You're absolutely right. All right. Goodbye.
He didn't want to talk to me?
No.
Well, why did he call?
He just called to make sure you were all right.
Really? What did he say?
He says he loves you very much and that you're a wonderful mother and a wife.
What else did he say?
Oh, it wasn't important.
What else did he say?
It was not that.
What else did he say?
But as a woman, you're as crazy as a bedbug.
Oh. Is that what that short hairless cowboy said? Well, you tell him he'll never find another woman like me if he lives to be 1,000.
Which bedroom do you want? The one you can see New Jersey, and the other you can see a guy who sleeps naked.
Yeah, I'm glad he called. He made me realize my marriage is finally over.
You want some sleeping pills? Take some sleeping pills.
I can't swallow them.
You can suck on them all night.
That actually doesn't sound so bad now. I think I can live with this thing.
Good. Live with it tomorrow. Go to bed tonight.
It'll just be 10 minutes. I just want to finish cleaning things up. Olive!
What?
I never knew you were so lonely. It must have been awful for you living here all night.